off for my second jab. Wish me luck. I'm spraying there. Danny's ploughing this. This is going to be spuds now. This is the wheat that we sown last November and it was rubbish, so we've written it off. Adam's spreading some fertiliser on it for Stuart. Chris is over there with one plough. Danny's here with another. So this was like the stubble that we'd sown wheat into and now it's crap. Anyways, he's going to plough it over. Adam will put the fertiliser on, then they'll come and grub it up. Then they'll destone it, ridge it up, and destone it, and then sow it with planting with potatoes. I'll get a video of this. So that's the plough, obviously ploughing it over, so it's getting the soil and it's rolling it completely upside down. Gets a bit of air into it and stuff, and it dries it out a bit quicker. It makes it less tight for them to get enough depth of soil for planting potatoes into it. Putting a fungicide on this field now because of that. If it focuses, let me flip the camera. See the little orange bits on it? Well, that's yellow rust. This variety is some that I kind of inherited, and it's prone to yellow rust, so put a fungicide on it now, stop it spreading, stop it making it worse, because it can basically take over the whole plant and then it can't photosynthesize and it basically just kills it, so you'd end up with a yellow or orange field of dead wheat. This is one that was sown with a clade and drill, so it's wider row spacing as well, which can actually help with the spread of viruses. It's not spreading as easily. It can get more airflow, you see, down the rows, which stops like its own microclimate that could cause diseases to sort of like fester in like a humid atmosphere. So we'll put a fungicide on it now. A few burr patches, a bit of a wet patch in front that's a bit flooded. But we need to put a drain from there to that pond. But otherwise, it's not too bad, to be fair. Plough's just pulled out the field and now they've got cultivator there ripping up the ground, leveling the soil out, and then this is the bed former now coming, and that'll make it into beds. And the destone is working. So once it's been ploughed, they go through and rip it up, and then they go through with the bed former and it makes beds, and then the destone has come through and make the beds look like this, and then the planter comes along and makes the drills and puts the potatoes in the ground at like different spacing depending on the variety. Anything from, I don't know, sort of 12, 14 inch, maybe up to about 20 inch. So the planter's just coming up the field now. I've missed the destoners. They've between, because I've been going between fields and they've been going between fields. But I'll try and get a video of them later. That's footprints from a bird. Let's go near the planter now and have a look. I think that planter can plant at about 12k. It flies because it's got belts on it that sort the potatoes out and put them in the ground. See it now. Just dropping them in the middle and then making the drills. The planter's isobus then?
Yes, it's all isobus. And when it gets to the end, it'll cut it off, because what I do, I put a headland in, so I go into the applications fields, so I map all the fields, that's this field here, 5.6 hectares, and then I go to boundaries, and I put a 20 metre headland in, so it stops on the dotted line all the way around.
So will it do either side independently as well, or just
the
plan through when it gets to the line?
But it's brilliant, it's absolutely phenomenal.
So then that bleeps, you know to lift up, spin it round and drop back in again?
Yeah, well you'll see when we get to the end here, it gets to the line, it'll stop, you'll hear a little bleep when we get to the line, and then I'll just lift up after we go through.
So, there you go. So no seeds wasted. And then the lads will come back, rip that headland up, bed ridge it, destone that, and then you'll sow the headland last.
Correct.
Found any golf balls?
So you don't want to find them in the factory then.
Oh well, yeah, they'll end up in the crisp packets, won't they?
That's not a healthy snack anymore.
Nah.
So, and you'll see it start here in a minute again. Yeah. So I'll put it in there at least it gets plenty of soil in there, so it's perfect rich. Away we go.
There you go. And then there's all these controls. And this is Stuart, by the way. These are for walkers?
Yes.
And there's the seed spuds. So what's how many acres is it on the spuds, 2 hectares?
It just varies on the size.
It depends on the size, yeah.
Yeah, but it tends to work out about 0.9 to 1 ton of potatoes at an acre. So
yeah.
about 2.4 to a hectare.
Yeah. Yeah, this one's nearly finished. They only started this about 2 hours ago. What speed are we going? 12k? 10k?
No, we are going 9.4k on the radar.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I can do like 30 to 32 eggs an hour, a day.
A day. Keeping busy. Just putting another bag of seed in now, and then it should get the rest of this field finished. Well, at least this corner. The lads will come back, work these headlands up, and then they'll sow that plant them as well. Just working out the headlands there. See how deep the tines go in there. Growling a bit doing the headlands. 7.5. That's loosened it all up now for the bed ridge that's over there, so we'll go and have a look at that. The bed ridge are now on another 7.5. Like a rotavator on the front, smashing it all up into little lumps, and the two ploughs on the back going in the opposite directions to make the ridges. And then the destoner will come along and chomp through that, take the stones out and put them in the bottom and bury them. A proper tractor in the field. They've got the destoner on, so it's pulling up the ridges now, shaking it and sieving it through, like a bit like what's in our screener bucket. Then it drops the cobbles into the bottom of this ridge here, and then that's what they're used to driving on. And in the middle should just be fine soil for growing the potatoes in. So when they lift the potatoes, they can shake the fine soil out of them and just have the potatoes in the trailer rather than cobbles and stones or golf balls. When you dig potatoes, stones that are similar size to potatoes, you can't separate. So that's why you grow them in a really fine soil. Admittedly, that'll get rained on and baked and different things, but most of it is took out before they're planted. Lots of golf balls, because there's a golf club there. But Stuart's got an optical sorter, so they won't end up in your crisp packet because it's optically sorted before they go to the factory. So that's how you plant potatoes, plough it, bit of fertiliser, rough it up, loosen it, level it off a bit more from the ploughing, smash some of the lumps up, then go through a bed ridger, like a rotavator from the front, puts it in ridges, and the destoners go through, and they sieve the soil, take the big lumps out, the stones and the golf balls, put all them in the wheelings where the tractor drives, and the planter goes along, parts the bed, open in two rows, drops potatoes every 32 centimetres, pulls the soil back over, and then you just wait a few months, and then when you go back, that one potato should have turned into about 15 crisp packet size crisp ones, maybe 20, depending on how much rain it gets. Harvest them, optical sorter takes any stones, soil and golf balls out, off to the factory, chopped up into crisps, you get them in a packet. That's the second field of oilseed rape that we sow, and it's just coming into flower now. You can see the far end of it though, sort of through them trees over there. It's still green, that's where the pigeons were eating it. But they didn't eat this bit by the road because they didn't like the cars driving past disturbing them. Then now, right on the far end, you can't see from here, but there's a load of beehives that were delivered last night. If I get a chance, I'll go and show you them tomorrow. But they'll be at work now on that, pollinating it. And then once that stops flowering, they'll move on to the beans the other side of that hedgerow over there. Andrew's found something that fits. And it works. Oh no, he's driven over it all. He's got the two iron driven over it. Oh no, that didn't work. He put the machine in float, but thinking he could get the to float, but for some reason it wants to drive over itself. Must be too much, the bristles too stiff.
Oh, that's self-levelized.
Right now. Yeah, that's no good that, is it? You'll have to just carry it slightly. Down a bit. Right, go on. No, it's too high. There we go. Not too bad. He's moving his log cages now. That's what it's made for. I've just missed filming it, but there's a whirlwind just gone across from there, where are we? There, right across there by them bales. And all the dust went right up into the sky, but I missed filming it. No whirlwind, but there's a hare just run around that corner now. Oh, and there's another one. Great to see. At least the dog men haven't had it. Got another one now. And that's three in this field. Good. I'm going to show this to you now. This is where, when this field was obviously sprayed off, I don't know whether it was with the herbicide in the wheat or before we drilled it, but you see that little triangle mist there with oilseed rape growing in it. So that's that just shows you how effective it would be if we hadn't sprayed the field. You see that it's like a totally patch of oilseed rape grown within the wheat. The whole field would look like that if the herbicide didn't work, you see. So it looks okay. That was the first field of oilseed rape, so pretty much in flower, apart from the far corner again where the pigeons are. Hope it evens up by harvest. Did I tell you I hate pigeons? Yesterday's quiz question was the border spread thing on a coon spreader. It works different on our one. Ours, it has this thing that adjusts where it falls on the disc. The ones with the fins on can create shattering, so when the fertilizer hits it, it kind of shatters it. So that's why Sulky have gone with this design. This is today's quiz question. Does anyone know what that's for? What it's off and why we've made it and what we use it for? If you think you do, leave a question, sorry, a comment below. Getting near the end of the day now. Obviously, that's how potatoes are grown. Lots of spud equipment today. I've obviously been spraying all day fungicide. I've had my jab this morning. It's making me a little bit sleepy. A little bit tired, to be honest. Hopefully, I won't be ill tomorrow like I was last time after the last one. But I'm going to keep taking paracetamol. Someone told me to take it before the jab. I didn't. And I took it when I got home. And I will keep taking it tonight just to make sure of it, like shake it off. Tomorrow, probably got some more spraying to do, and we'll have a close look at them fence as well. And then if I am ill, at least I'm not out and about working too hard, I suppose. So thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing. I've got an outro now from Kieran, and also if you watch every day, click like, and then I'll try and gauge how many people are watching every day, because YouTube sort of makes out how many people watch it, but it doesn't tell me whether it's the same group of people. Get me? So anyway, see you tomorrow.